country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my friend. And I'm in the midnight again. What a beautiful day.
Was geht hier denn ab? Was für ein strange Anfang in die Folge. William, definitiv.
This isn't right.
Ja, in dieser Welt hier schon.
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad.
Aber das ist doch ganz klar, William. Na, ich würde sagen, reden wir doch mal.
If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
Uh-oh. Was ein Anfang in die Folge. Oh je, oh je. Ja, so hat sich Williams Tod beigetragen, wie wir es bereits aus Life is Strange kennen. Als hätte Chloe es miterlebt. Gott sei Dank war sie nicht im Auto. Naja, mal gucken. Sind wir jetzt wieder in der echten Welt?
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything. Hello, Black Hell.
Da ist sie wieder, die gute alte Blackwell Academy. Mal schauen, was sich alles so verändern wird in den nächsten 3 Jahren. 2010 zu 2013.
Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you wanna go together tomorrow?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in camp.
Yeah, for sure.
Dann ist ja gut. Den kenne ich aber gar nicht. Ich hätte seinen Abschluss bereits.
Ich muss Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Ah, cool, das wusste ich auch. Was habe ich jetzt gemacht? ET? Was ist ein ET? Ja, die eigentlich. Ja, moin. Das ist ja cool gemacht. Ich dachte mir gerade die ganze Zeit, was geht mit der Kamera ab? So, das ist das Theater.
Maybe.
Wir werden es rausfinden.
Well, at least not for now.
999 Science Fiction Film Club. Treffen 17:30 ist das Ist dir das Genre neu? Bestellen dich dir einen Klassiker vor. Hast du einen Filmvorschlag? Sprich mit Warren oder Brooke. Ah, cool, dann werden wir also auch wieder treffen.
How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance?
Drogen, sie machen dich fertig. Ja, gut, dass wir welche dabei haben, hust hust. Ah, Steph schreibt. Ey, hey, ich bin beim Picknicktischchen mit Mikey. Danke, bin auf dem Weg. Was sollten wir mal ausnutzen? Wir können ein paar weitere, Mikey und Steph, kenne ich beide tatsächlich nicht und das ist falsch rum, by the way. So, wir haben aber ein neues Tagebucheinträgchen. Oh, ziemlich viel. 5.3. Mhm, das kennen wir. Ja, das kennen wir auch schon. Oder? Hm. Ja, das haben wir schon gelesen. Max, die Verliererin. Das haben wir auch schon, glaube ich. Ja, das haben wir schon. Mhm. Ja, hier waren wir zuletzt. Okay. Max, du weißt ja, wie es mir so vorkam, es könnten die Dinge zwischen Mama und mir nicht schlimmer werden. Ha! Die traurige Wahrheit ist, auf einmal muss ich mitentscheiden, ob ich nett oder ehrlich zu ihr sein will. Denn beides geht nicht. Aber wie soll ich weiterhin nett sein und tun, als treffe sie keine fürchterliche Entscheidung mit dem Schnurrbart? Und warum bin ich die Einzige, die sich wegen der feindlichen Übernahme unseres Hauses sorgt? Heute in Wechselkasten und Schnurrbart, Schmorbraten, morgen? Ich sollte hier aufhören, mehr geistige Gesundheit zuliebe. Honest Will und Nice Borg. Cool, richtig cool gemacht. Ja, ich weiß, dass Mama sich wegen dem Geld Sorgen macht, aber das rechtfertigt ihren fürchterlichen Männergeschmack nicht. Außerdem weiß Mama, dass ich schwänze, was scheiße ist, aber auf gewisse Art fühle ich mich besser. Bedeutet das, dass ich ein schlechter Mensch bin, dass es mich nicht kümmert, dass ich schwänze und dass ich nur erleichtert bin, nicht mehr lügen zu müssen? Antworte besser nicht darauf. Chloe, der nutzlos schlechte Mensch. Oh je. Max, 7.5. Der Schnurrbart hat mich zur Schule gefahren heute mal. Ja, so läuft mein Leben. Noch schlimmer, er dachte, diese Fahrt wäre eine Gelegenheit, mir zu sagen, wie die Dinge von jetzt an laufen. Ich habe versucht, die Scheiße zu beenden, aber er hat's durchgezogen und mir seine dumme Predigt gehalten übers Leben, den Krieg und ich weiß nicht, Suppe? Ich habe nicht aufgepasst. Hab wieder von Papa geträumt, der Traum, in dem ich dort war, als es passierte. Es wird jedes Mal schwerer, mich zu erinnern, was echt ist und was nicht. Nach dem Aufwachen weiß ich nur, wie sehr ich ihn vermisse. Ich hoffe, das hört nie auf. Die Chloe, die nicht dort war, oder doch? Ich glaube leider nicht. David und Joyce. Trotz aller Mühe, die Mama sich gibt, hasse ich sie nicht. Ich weiß, es ist hart, sein Papas Tod. Das Geld ist knapp, ihr Job als Kellnerin im Diner ist gerade glamourös und mir liegt nicht viel daran, zur Schule zu gehen. Aber warum muss sie uns beiden so viel schwerer machen? Sie tut so, als sei es ein persönlicher Angriff auf sie, wenn ich kiffe oder die Schule schwänze. Sie sollte sich freuen, dass ich mir selbst Medizin verabreiche, statt auf alle loszugehen. Sie war nie so, als Papa noch hier war. Und tatsächlich cool sein. Ach, vor kurzem hat sie ein haariges Monster ins Haus gelassen, das alles ruiniert. David Madsen, ein arbeitsloser, hirnloser und schwanzloser Scheißer, der auf alles steht, was mit Militär zu tun hat. Und ich versprach, mich gerade zu biegen. Arschloch. Ich habe versucht, diese Bedenken gegenüber Mama zu Ausdruck zu bringen. Doch mit jeder Woche scheint sie den Virus in einem weiteren Winkel ihres Lebens auszubreiten. Ich beginne mir Sorgen zu machen, dass die David-Pest die Sorte Krankheit ist, die einen Wirt umbringt. Das hoffen wir doch nicht, beziehungsweise wir wissen es, denn David ist gar nicht so schlimm, wie wir schon erfahren haben. Was Blackwood-Schüler angeht, ist Elliot Hampton nicht so übel. Er hängt manchmal mit einigen der Idioten rum, aber ich habe den Eindruck, dass er eher ein einsamer Wolf ist, wie ich. Ähnlich wie bei meinem Stundenplan haben Elliot und ich gemeinsame Geschichte. War kein Theater, die Chemie stimmt nicht. Wir haben ein paar Mal rumgemacht, kurz nachdem Papa gestorben ist. Aber da war nicht viel dran. Ich glaube, ich war bloß gelangweilt. Oder ein wenig einsam. Seltsam, ich weiß. Ich verstehe Elliot manchmal nicht. Er fragt mich ständig, ob wir was unternehmen, was nett ist. Aber ich bin nicht immer sicher, dass wir noch viel gemeinsam haben. Wenn er mit mir spricht, kommt es mir gelegentlich so vor, als studiere er mich. Ich weiß nicht, ob er nur befreundet sein will oder an die Wäsche will. Ich schätze beides als Kompliment. Es interessiert mich nur nicht sonderlich. Sorry, Elliot. Und ich würde sagen, Mikey und Steph werden wir reden, wenn wir sie besser kennen.
Hey, Skip. Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today. I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Badass.
Ja, krass.
You know how I roll.
So, I went to the mill last night. Cut Firewalk live.
Yeah, I can see that. Wait, you went to the mill last night?
It was cool.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
What? Like good music?
Preach it, sister.
I'm dann ist ja alles gut.
No shit. Really?
We're called Pisshead. It's not a big deal or anything. I mean I'm trying to get our demo out there, but it's hard.
Pisshead, huh?
Would you maybe want to hear it? Our demo, I mean.
Ja, klar doch.
Yeah, okay.
Great.
Ich bin gespannt. Also Musik kann man in dem Spiel bis jetzt sehr, sehr gut hören. Aber das reicht mir schon.
So, what did you think?
Also ich weiß, dass Chloe auf sowas steht, deswegen, also ich persönlich fand jetzt okay. Ich meine, es hatte einen guten Rhythmus und einen guten Beat. Ich sag einfach mal echt gut.
Really good, man. If Pisshead came on the radio, I'd turn that shit up.
Oh, right on. Awesome, Chloe, thanks.
No problem. Ich baue gerne auf. Obwohl Chloe eigentlich nicht so die Person ist und im letzten Mal war ich sehr, sehr böse, das weiß ich noch. Naja, Miss Grant.
Morning, Miss Grant.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins.
Wer weiß. Und sehr wahrscheinlich, ich will das Mysterium nicht ruinieren.
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad. Maybe in another 6 months, a new donor will come along with money for, I don't know, more lasers.
More lasers?
Do we have any lasers?
Sadly, no.
That is sad.
Auf jeden Fall.
I'll see you in class, right, Chloe?
Wir werden es rausfinden, wie gesagt. Do not walk on the stage. Ja, das werden wir gleich mal ausprobieren. Eigentlich dürfen wir hier nicht weiter. Genauso wie Max. Ah, es ist so schön, wieder hier zu sein, am Blackway rumzulaufen. Wie wir es auch in Episode 1 und F-Strange gemacht haben.
I prefer to wake and bake, but hey. To each their own.
Schüler von Blackwell, verpasst nicht die wichtigste Mahlzeit des Tages. Bendet euren Körper richtig während der Stresse der Abschlussprüfungen.
But fire's so pretty.
Tragt euren Teil zum Brandschutz bei. Oh wow, bestes Kommentar von Chloe. So, wenn du jetzt sagst, ich darf da nicht hoch, das wäre sehr komisch. Wir machen es einfach und Chloe gibt sowieso keinen Fuck auf irgendwas. Sorry, dass ich das so sage. Aber es ist leider so. Oh cool, hinsetzen. Spielst du uns jetzt was vor? Nee, denk mal wieder.
I should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care.
Das denke ich mir. Mehr sagst du gar nicht, doch.
Really happened? The internet says it did, but I still can't believe it. Rachel Amber. The drama star, honor student, popular princess of Blackwell. Swoops in like Batman to save my ass and thrash to firewalk? Either that was a dream or real life just got a shit ton crazier.
Ist auf jeden Fall krass. Ich find's cool, dass sie da noch nicht mal befreundet waren. Aber Rachels erster Auftritt und einziger bis jetzt fand ich wirklich cool. Oh. Upsi.
Principal Wells. Hey. Stay cool, Chloe. You've got a marijuana.
Oh, jetzt werden wir einen Dings wieder, einen Fight haben.
Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage. Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
Ich war's nicht, ich schwör's. Wie steht's mit kleinen Übertretungen?
How many minor infractions and a major one?
This is no joke, Miss Price.
Who's joking? You've seen my math grades.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell has a zero tolerance policy. And yet if my olfactory sense does not fail me, I'd say you've recently been exposed to marijuana smoke.
Shit.
Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price?
Uh-oh. Ich hab's dabei. Beziehungsweise Chloe jetzt mitgenommen.
That's what I thought. I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today.
Uh-oh.
How does that sound?
Okay. Okay, wir können es noch rausholen.
He has it out for me. I have to convince him it's in his best interest to back off.
Oh je, jetzt haben wir wieder wenig Zeit wahrscheinlich.
I'm gonna go with no.
Ah.
Ja klar, er muss nur einmal.
And here I thought your well of witticisms had finally run dry.
Super, ich muss dreimal.
Seriously, I really
do. Er hat gewonnen. Ich sollte links drücken. Verdammt!
Your words alone have convinced me of your guilt.
Verdammt, verdammt, verdammt. Mich kotzt es an, ich bin zu blöd für die Sachen hier. Ich brauche mehr.
Just great.
Kann ich nicht zurückspulen? Please, sei doch Chloe. Er seid auch Max, meine ich. Ach, verdammt, was habe ich getan? Ich bin so blöd, Leute. Ich sollte das rechte nehmen. Ich habe ja links genommen. Blöd, blöd, blöd. Aber ich finde es cool, dass wir so, dass der, also der ist wirklich nett, der Aufsichtsmann da, der mal David wird.
Flowers always make me think of springtime, which makes me think of summer, which makes me think of getting the fuck away from Blackwell for 3 whole months. I love flowers. This makes being high sound like a bad thing.
Was? Fire danger rating today. High, das geht ja noch. Weil was da noch für Stoßen gibt.
Pretty good. I'd never tell him that, of course.
Natürlich. Die Gefahren von Waldbränden von Evan Harris. Ja, das sieht echt nicht schlecht aus. So, ich möchte mal jetzt... Oh mein Gott. Tatsächlich, das ist Victoria. Krass.
The future needs excellence. The future is an asshole.
Da bin ich jetzt aber gespannt, wie sie so drauf ist.
Oh, Carrie Price.
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that, what with Rachel Amber. Am I right?
Wait, what about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
Wir haben den Kerl umgebracht.
Tell what, Victoria? It's a photo. Big deal.
But it's on Facebook. I mean, that basically means you and Rachel are like BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh.
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
Uh-oh.
You? Help me?
Das war nicht gut.
That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, and uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey, thanks, Carrie.
No problem.
Oh je, ich hatte auf jeden Fall, ich hab's nicht bereut, zu Victoria so nett gewesen zu sein im ersten Teil. Deswegen weiß ich nicht, ob das so toll ist, dass wir jetzt so gar nicht, dass wir jetzt schon was Böses zu ihr gemacht haben, aber naja.
See you in class.
Okay. So, Justin, moin.
Hey, price check. Gotten in any good trouble lately?
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north. Kind of a DIY thing.
Wow, no shit. I thought that place was like meth central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever. It was cool, okay? You wouldn't understand.
Wow.
Hey, out of the blue question, what do you think of Rachel Amber?
She is amazing. If you're into chicks that are hot. Smart and hot. I mean, she helped me out a while back. I was failing algebra hard.
I believe you.
Check it. After I bombed my midterm last fall, she tutored me for the rest of the semester. And then I crushed it. C+.
All right. Guess I'll see you in class.
Word.
Wow, eine 3 ist aber echt nicht so schlecht, wenn er davor durchgefallen wäre. Das ist ja echt eine gute Besserung auf jeden Fall. Wer bist du? Ach, Evan. Ach, dich kenne ich sogar. Ja, ja. Ach, da vorne sind die.
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess.
Waldbrände sind super. Ich wollte noch sagen, dieser Evan hat eine echt komische Stimme, so eine richtige Computerstimme, keine Ahnung. Achtet da mal drauf.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
Nein.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Alles, um den Unterricht fernzubleiben. Ich bin jetzt mal Chloe-like.
I really don't care that much.
Doing nothing is just as bad as doing harm.
Pretty sure that's not true.
Sorry. Es tut mir wirklich leid, aber... Sie juckt es halt echt überhaupt nicht, deswegen sollte sie es auch nicht unterschreiben, finde ich. Ich wollte mal kurz gucken. Ja, tatsächlich, es gibt... Nee, Seite 6 war die letzte. Ich frage mich immer noch, was ich hier machen kann. Du musst wundern. Oh. You don't drink. Eckett free candy inside. Oh ja, die zwei haben wir schon. Was Spitzes. Glückliches Balk. Das alte Auto. Toter weißer Typ. Theaternerds. Gefängnis und. Ach, das alles kann man. David Schrott. Ja, das ist jetzt too late, kann ich mal sagen, ne? Gefängniswand, interessant. Ja gut, ich wollte noch mit diesem Mädchen da vorne reden. Die kenne ich gar nicht. Ja, Samantha. Hä? Ah.
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyt's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
Wie hieß der Titel? Ich habe nicht aufgepasst.
The story is about how relationships only work if people are willing to lie to each other.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
I bet.
Irgendwie hat die gar kein Selbstvertrauen. Das ist ja krass.
I really didn't mean anything.
Okay, du hast trotzdem überhaupt kein Selbstvertrauen. Kann mit dem Fahrrad? Nee, leider nicht. Ja gut, dann gehen wir jetzt mal zu den zwei. Kann man eigentlich da durch? Bestimmt nicht. Ja, dachte ich mir. So. Hey, ihr beiden. Danach lesen wir mal über die zwei.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Das.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
Ich finde beide Antworten jetzt blöd. Was kümmert's euch? Ist so, ist doch euch scheißegal. Und wir sind keine Freunde? Ja, wir sind eigentlich noch keine.
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
Okay.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Wir haben halt echt sonst nichts mehr, was wir tun sollten.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as
das war mehr der Humor von ihr.
I know, I'm good. All right, let's get started. You were both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
Calamastia.
Calamastia.
Yeah.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
Laut meinen Charakterbogen. Ich liebe den Humor.
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Gefängnislager, weil wir brauchen was vom Gefängnis im Tagebuch.
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Come on.
Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common. Which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand really? Every yeah. word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use-
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
I wiggle my hand. Hey, Dragon King guy. Want to become my meat puppet?
Yeah.
How it works is I shove my arm up your ass into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do I.
The Dragon King pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
You're short, I say. But I could fix that. I'll just cut off your head and wear it as a top hat. Then you'd be way taller.
The dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go.
So geil.
That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Verstört.
Wow.
That was nuts.
I'm going to give you a +10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
Wir machen den Kriegerherr natürlich als letztes.
Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Fataler Knaufschlag. Nein, fataler Spalter
okay.
Hört sich gut an.
Let's end this. Fatal Cleave.
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game!
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
My character raises her axe. You'll pay for ruining all that loot, Elamon.
By my honor, I apologize. Here, take this potion as a
sehr gut.
Thanks, dude.
What's next?
Naja.
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black.
Sieht aus wie Ganon.
Sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur. Swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit! All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
Wutsturm.
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
I want to punch that stupid man cow in the dick.
Like, right in the dick?
Right in the dick.
You miss. Durgaron burst out laughing as you stumble past him.
Asshole.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
Ouch.
What do you do next?
Holy shit! Annihilation strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
1?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, 3.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
This game is awesome.
My feet?
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
tanze. Nein, ich opfer mich nicht.
I say something really encouraging to Elamon.
Like what?
Yeah. Like what?
Shit. Why is being nice so hard? Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were.
You just cut off my feet.
Elamon feels inspired. He summons the strength necessary to crawl away from Durgaron. Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I take one last swing at Durface's head.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Oh no.
11. You swing, catching Durgaron on the side of his head, severing one horn, but you don't do enough damage to kill him.
What an asshole!
He laughs, then rips you off his sword with a vicious jerk. You die painfully.
So mean.
I'm sorry, Chloe. I have to escape.
Hey, man. If you can, do it.
I cast Warden's Hideaway.
You sure?
It's all I've got.
You summon a spectral door, which shields you from Durgaron. Light flares out, blinding him. The door swings shut, then disappears. You are gone from sight and cannot be harmed.
I guess I'll have to come back when I'm stronger.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry I died and left you out there to fend for yourself.
It's cool. I'll get him. Eventually.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.